Hello, Cheapskaters. Welcome to part two of our Spring Clean Your Finances series. We spring clean our homes to get rid of the dust and mustiness of winter. And this week I've been spring cleaning the craft room, not that you'd know it at the moment, and my office area. And we should do the same thing with our finances. It just makes sense to freshen things up and make sure everything is working as it should be. I'm Kath Armstrong, creator of the Cheapskates Club, where our goal is to live life debt-free, cashed up and laughing. If you're new to our channel, welcome. You have found us at a great time, spring cleaning time. This week, we're going to look at spending plans. Some of you may call them budgets, and update them where and if necessary. Now, if you were with us last week, you've been faithfully tracking your spending for the week. You have, haven't you? And you'll have a much better than fair idea of how your spending is actually going. This week, it's time to take that information and use it to update your spending plan. Spending plans, or budgets for those who like the B word, well, they're not set in cement. They are meant to be fluid. They're meant to change and adapt as your circumstances do. And, you know, circumstances for most of us have changed a lot recently. So that won't happen without regular reviews. Those reviews don't need to take long, just a few minutes every couple of months to make sure you're on track and living to your spending plan. Now, I do a really quick 10 minutes max review of our spending plan each week. It's usually on a Sunday afternoon when things are quiet and we can relax and I can concentrate on what I'm doing. It makes sure I know that we haven't overspent any categories in our budget or our spending plan. And I use the time to schedule bill payments and to file any paperwork that needs to be kept, because, oh boy, we might be in a paperless society, but we still have heaps that needs to be kept. But once a month, Wayne and I sit down together and we go over our complete spending plan. Now, it's not always a fun exercise. For starters, Wayne is more than happy to leave the nerdy stuff like spreadsheets and bank balances and so on to me. He also trusts me implicitly to ensure that our family finances are straight. And that's something I don't take for granted. It's a huge responsibility. And I don't ever want to take advantage of this responsibility, especially for our family. It means it's, you know, it's a difference between how our family works. We're a team, and as a team, we need to both know our financial situation. So sometimes when the footy's on, or there's a particularly excited car race on, or cricket's on, or he'd rather be doing anything but sitting at the table with me crunching numbers, well, you know, he needs just a tiny, tiny little bit of encouragement. We do it together because we both need to know where things stand. This is our spending plan review. It's a routine that works for us. I'm going to share it with you, and you can follow our steps or arrange them to suit yourself. Now, the first one's easy. Set a day and time. Now, we use the first Sunday of the month. It works for us because I know Wayne will be home. He's on call the first weekend of every month, so unless he's out in a job, he's at home waiting for the phone to ring. I time it usually for just after lunch if I can, because then we're already sitting at the table, we've been fed, we're happy, we're relaxed, and it's usually before any really exciting sport comes on TV. Now, if you have small children, that won't work for you, or it may not work for you. You might need to find a half an hour after they're in bed of an evening, or while they're having an afternoon nap. You find the time that works best for you. Just choose a day and time when you can sit down together and go through the finances without interruptions. Number two, and that's an easy one too, well, it is for us with grown-up children, is hide. Get away from distractions. Now, we use the laptop so we can cart it around with us. We can pull up all our accounts on it and we can take it to the table with us. Because when we're at the table, there's no distractions, there's no TV, we won't be tempted by our phones or whatever. So hide. That's important too, so that you can concentrate. Number three is come prepared. Now, before each meeting, each budget meeting, I make sure our spending plan is up to date. Now, it's pretty easy to do because I check it each week. I have the bill folder with me, all the bills to be paid are in it. Any other things that we need to discuss are handy within reach. I bring the receipt envelope. It's just an envelope that I tuck the receipts in, guys, nothing fancy. Wayne brings his wallet. That's his receipt envelope where he shoves all his receipts and any mini statements from the bank so that we can check them. So that we can check those things against our actual bank statement. Then if there's any discrepancies, we can jump on them straight away. Step four, we go through our receipts, our tracking notes. I have a little notebook that I write down what I spend. And I use those things to bring the spending plan up to date for the year. It's easy, four steps. I find out if I'm on track in all the categories, if I've overspent in some, if we've overspent, will the deficit be made up by the end of the year? If we've underspent in some categories, what are we going to do with it? Will the categories balance by the end of the year? If we have an excess, are we going to put it into our emergency fund or our savings or leave it in that category to build up for the next year? Sounds like a lot, but it's not really. It only takes a moment. If a category is in surplus, do we adjust the amount down so that we can move the money into something else that needs a boost? Just little things, but they need to be discussed and they need to be actioned. Number five, keep it simple and fun. For a lot of people, figures and numbers are boring. They don't understand them. They don't want to understand them. They don't want to know. So keep it simple and fun. Now, I like figures. I like working with numbers. We do it once a month. It takes no more than half an hour, literally half an hour. Now, we could whiz through it in probably 15 minutes if we had to. But we don't mind the time together. It's nice and quiet. We get to talk. We usually have a coffee, cup of tea, and dessert because we don't have dessert all the time. So dessert's a treat. we have it while we're going over our spending plan. It makes it more fun, less work. We get through the bookwork really quickly and we both know exactly where we stand financially. That is so important. It doesn't matter whether you run your spending plan on a spreadsheet, in a computerized budgeting program, or, you know, the old-fashioned way in a ledger book. It doesn't matter how you do it as long as you keep the records up to date. Because if they're not up to date, you really do not know where you stand financially. You need to be able to see at a glance just how well your spending plan is working. Now remember, they're not set in cement. They're meant to change. They're meant to adapt to your financial situation. But regular reviews ensure that you are always right on budget. Easy. If you have any questions, please put them in the comments below. I read every comment and I do my best to answer every question. And before I go, thank you so much for watching. Remember, like, subscribe, share. If you're not already subscribed to our channel, please click that subscribe button and then the little bell next to it and choose how often you want to be notified of new videos we put up. Don't forget to like, just click the thumbs up, and share by clicking the share button to help us spread the word that it is not only okay to live life debt-free, cashed up and laughing, but it is absolutely possible even in 2022. I'll be back next week with part 3 of our financial spring clean. See you then.